Hi everyone, my name's Amy. I don't know if you remember me. Not surprised if you don't, because I haven't made a video in about 18 months. Sorry for that. Been a bit busy. So I was the Monday Submariner, but I sort of retired for about a good year. Didn't do any videos, didn't do any content. So I would like to reintroduce myself for those of you who are new to the channel and also to the new Submariners. Hi to everyone, and we hit 500 subscribers, which I'm really pleased about. So yeah, my name's Amy. Hi, I'll be making videos every Monday, hopefully. Don't call me to that. Don't really know what else to say apart from a massive thank you to everyone who has managed to stick around for this long. Got a bit of a hefty uptake to do. I can now drive, which is something I couldn't do previously in my videos. I have got a new guitar. I don't know if you can see. I also got a mandolin, which I'm regretting because I've learnt two songs, everyone. I got a new guitar for my 18. It's very nice. I love it. It's very busy. I've noticed that there are a couple of tags going around my channel. One is the alphabet challenge, and the second one is a show your vinyl tag, which I would greatly love to do. I don't know if you follow me on Instagram or Twitter or any of them sites, I don't know. But I'm massive at collecting records. I've got a lot, and it's gonna take about a good half hour if I was to do a video about them. So if that's something you would like to see, then let me know in the comments. I've been a bit busy. I finished school the other week. I've been here, there, and everywhere, pardon the pun, going to various concerts and gigs. I come back from one in London of all places, last week. London isn't local for me, by the way. It's about a 5-hour drive. I don't know why I got tickets, but it's a good gig. Got a couple of more gigs coming up. Nothing particularly classic rock related, just a couple of good artists that I like, whose work I enjoy. Not been making my videos. My room's sort of been redecorated. I honestly can't remember the last time I did a video, and I honestly can't remember what my last setup was. So, CDs, ukulele. Excuse me, my voice is broken. Some DVDs. Well, I can't even really point there. There's some DVDs. A really cute picture of Robert Plant and Roger Daltrey, who are my two favourite people. Other than George Harrison, just saying. A couple of lists of things which need to get done, i.e. this video needs to get done. And that's that chef. Do you know what? I might as well do a room tour while I'm at it. Massive sorry if you thought I vanished off the face of the earth. I'd like to thank Karen and Jamie for being the backbone of this channel for the past God knows how long, because without them I probably wouldn't have strived to do this video. Hi to new viewers and new submariners, lovely to meet you. Let's shake hands, there we go, sorted. And thank you to 500 subscribers, because that's a lot. Also thank you, massive thank you to 500 subscribers. I don't know how long this channel has been going on for, maybe 3 years, something like that. So 500, it's a lot, and we've all grown up. I mean, I started when I was 15, which is incredibly young. I mean, I got to the Beatles when I was 14, started this. I'd say started, I mean, Brittany and I sort of conjured up the idea. And I'm like, hey guys, Karen, Jamie, Natalie, Kimberly, let's go, let's make a channel. So that's what that happened. I know how to get a party going on, people suddenly, let's go, huh? Can you see that dedication in the hat? And, are you ready? Sorry, disclaimer, if anyone is nervous or jumpy or do not like poppy things, I suggest you pause this video. That was a little party to celebrate 500. So yeah, leave some comments. Don't know what that was. Leave some comments below about punishments if you wish, suggestions for future videos. If you want to see a record collection, because I'm in Love Records. I don't know if you know this. I've got like three, four copies of the same album, just different pressings, because I'm really weird like that. I like to get different pressings, different albums. Does that make sense? No? Okay. I'll try to explain more what I mean. If I get the opportunity to do a record video, this is one example of where I have 5 copies of one album. 3 are on vinyl, 1 is on cassette, and 1 is on CD, which is Rubber Soul. Not gonna lie, it's not even my favourite Beatles album. It's just happened to come across different copies one day, bought them on a whim. There we are. This is an original UK mono pressing. This is an Italian pressing. I don't know if you can tell the difference. I certainly could. The logo's different. It was released on EMI. And look at the difference. And the backs as well. Oh, excuse me. Even the backs are totally different. So that's a UK pressing original from 1965. I don't think it's an original Italian, but it definitely is Italian. I have done my research because I'm weird like that, sorry. And this one is the most expensive record I ever bought. I'm trying to count the price because I'm ashamed of how much I paid for this, but you'll see why. Wait for it. This is German, I believe. I'm a sucker for code. So, yeah, just a little preview of some records which I own. I love having something physical to touch. Does that make sense? Like the buying of the record, the opening of the record, the pulling out the record from the sleeve, putting it on the turntable, then getting the sentimentality. Sorry, this video's been a bit lacklustered. In conclusion, thank you, sorry, and comment. See you next week.